Welcome back to Earls Court, where we're going from a car with a massive internal combustion engine to a car with an engine that might just be the answer to all our fuel problems. Here's Richard with an electric-powered exhibit.
Yes, indeed, Shaw, and this year's electric exhibit is in fact an electric taxi. It's designed and developed by Lucas and Ogle, and they did the body and chassis work. Just a couple of vital statistics. Its top speed is claimed to be 55 miles an hour, and it's said to have a range of 100 miles between battery recharging. That actually compares very favourably with the Enfield electric car, which only does 40 miles an hour and has a range of only 40 miles between recharging. Well, the man who heads the Lucas electric vehicle building programme is Geoffrey Harding. Geoff, does this mean that you're going into this side of the business?
No, we're not going to manufacture vehicles, but we have to produce a certain number of vehicles in order to try our development equipment.
And this is a taxi. Why not a car?
Well, the economics of a car are not as good as those of a taxi, largely because they don't run as many miles in a year, and an electric vehicle saves money when it runs miles.
Does this mean to say that, in fact, it's a better bet than the conventional taxi, for instance?
Well, this vehicle would run if it was in service as though fuel was 10 or 12p a gallon. Its initial cost is probably higher than an IC engine vehicle, but I think, on balance, you would save a lot of money operating one of these.
But you still use lead-acid batteries, quite heavy, always the limiting factor, surely?
Well, what matters with electric vehicles is whether they can do the job for which they're designed. We think the range that this vehicle will be capable of is sufficient for the normal operation of a taxi, and therefore the lead-acid battery is not a limitation in that case.
So still a glimpse into the future anyway. Thank you very much indeed. Now, though, let's catch up, though, with an issue of today. Very much so indeed. Back to Shaw Taylor.